Hello. So now we are going to deal with the control and the function keys. So the first is control F1, which is hide or unhide the taskbar. Now this is the taskbar. If you don't want to use this taskbar again and again, so what you can do, simply click on the control and F1 and see, it hides the taskbar. So it's not important. You can unhide it using this particular button over here, which is expand the ribbon option. And you can see the shortcut written over here as the control plus F1 key. So you can just simply click on this arrow, or you can use the control F1 to expand your taskbar or the ribbon. Then we have the control F2 is the open print option. So you can simply get the print review by clicking on control F2. And we have the print review, we have the page numbers over here, we have all the options which you can change, the margins, the scalings and all those stuffs. I'll just click on control P to go back again. Or what you can do, you can click on the escape button as well to move back to wherever you started. So you can just click on the escape and you can move, you can come back. Then we have the control F3, which is the open name manager. If you all remember, the name manager is there in my formulas tab. You have the name manager over here. So instead of going to the formulas tab and opening the name manager, you can use the shortcut key as control F3. So I'll just use control F3 and my name manager opens up. And in this name manager, you can give a particular name to this particular cell. So I can just simply... Okay, so it takes me to here, this particular sheet. I'll just go back to the original sheet in which I was, the shortcuts sheet. And here, I can simply select the cell which I want to rename. Basically, if I want to rename this particular cell. And, or I'll just click on the new basically. And you can just simply do the changes you want to. So again, I'll show you all. It's control F3, and this opens up. If you want to change any of the already existing named ranges, you can do that from here. You can simply select it and you can change it from here, or you can add, or you can add new names if you want to, or you can simply edit the existing ones or delete some of the existing ones. So this is the name manager. Then we have the control F4, which is the close current workbook. So this is the current workbook, and if I click on the control F4, so it simply closes. It asks me whether you want to save the changes. So, and then you can just simply save your answer, save your work done, and close your workbook. So that was your control F4. Now the next few options which we are going to see, which is control plus F5, F6, F8 till F9, which you are going to see, are the options which you see by right clicking over here. So on the top, on the very top, when you just simply right click, you get an option of restoring your workbook, minimizing. What do I mean by restoring is simply by resizing, clicking on this. So this is nothing but the option to restore down your workbook. So that was the restore option. So I just right click anywhere on the top of your workbook, you get these options, and you see the same shortcuts we can use from here as well. So it says F5 says restore the window size. So if I click on control F5, it basically, what it does is that it, you can see it minimizes my, or it restores down. It restores down my current workbook. So this is Data Analytics Excel 2, which is my current workbook, and what it has done, it has simply restored it down. Again, when you want to restore it back to the original size, what do you do is you use a new shortcut, which is control plus F10, which is maximize or restore the selected workbook window again. So I'll click on control F10 and it again expands. So control F5 is restoring it down, control F5, and control F10 is restoring it back to the maximum size. So that was a control F5 and control F10. The next we have control F6. So when you have more than one workbook open in your screen, in your desktop, then you can navigate through clicking on Control F6. So Control F6 takes me to the different workbook. As you can see over here, Data Analytics Excel 1. So this is the new workbook. This is a different workbook which is there. I have two workbooks opened over here. So Control F6 will take me back to this original workbook where I was dealing with. So that was the next workbook. When you have more than one workbooks open, if you have only single workbook, then obviously it won't, nothing will happen. Then we have the Control F7, which is activate move window cursor, provided window is not maximized. Now this is a very interesting thing which I'll explain you all. Before that I need to minimize, because it's given provided that the window is not maximized, so the window should not be maximized. So I'll click on Control F5. Obviously Control F5 will minimize my workbook. You can see it minimizes, it basically restores down my workbook. And then by clicking on F7, I can just simply navigate, I can just simply move. If I see, this is how you move a particular workbook. You are using a single you're just using the cursor and you're just moving the workbook like this using the mouse. Now if you don't have the mouse and you want to do it without the use of the mouse, what do? You just click on Control F7 and you see your cursor has changed. And now simply you can just click on the right. You see, I'm just clicking on the right arrow key and it's moving right, left arrow key, up arrow key, down arrow key. So this is how. And again, when you want to go back to the normal, you click on Control F7. And now when I click on the right, you just click on Control F7 again. And now it turns to normal. So this is how you work out. And then I'll just maximize this again. Okay, let us move on to the next, which is Control F8, which is activate resize window cursor. So this was the move window. You can simply move your window by using your left and the right arrow keys once you have clicked the Control F7. Now what you can do is you can just simply use change the size of this window without even using your mouse. How do you do that? You use Control F8. The moment you do Control F8, and now I click on the right side, you can see over here this is moving. I'm just clicking on the right arrow key, left arrow key, right arrow key, and this is how you can just simply resize your window. So that was Control F7. Control F7 will move your window. It will turn the cursor into a move window cursor, and you can just use the arrow keys to move your window. Similarly, F8 is used to resize the window. You can use the arrow keys to resize your window. Once clicked on Control F8, again I'll just click on Control F8 and just change this down back again. Next we have Control F9, which minimizes my workbook. So Control F9 will minimize my workbook, and this is the Data Analytics Excel 1. This is the second workbook which I have already opened. So this my workbook minimized basically. That was your Control F9, which will minimize your workbook. Then we have, or you could have used, instead of using the cursor, you could have used Control F10 to again get this workbook back. Then we have Control F11, which is a new macro sheet. So macro is basically it opens a new sheet in which you can do your all the macros. I'll just explain you. Control F11, and this opens a new worksheet. Now this worksheet, the name given is macro 1. When you click on Control F11, it will open a new worksheet which is with the name of macro 2. So you can see the names macro 1 and macro 2. So you can simply do all your macros over, consider all, doing all your macros over here. I'll just go back again. And then we have the last one, which is Control F12, which is to open a new workbook. So Control, or an existing workbook, Control F12. And see, you can navigate through and open your existing workbook wherever you want, wherever it is located in your desktop or in your PC. You can just select that and you can click on open to open that particular workbook. So this is how you use the function keys along with the control button. Thank you.